Yes.
I want to only preach for at most 5 minutes.
Amen.
In the past 1 week, the Lord has been laying a burden in my spirit.
Amen.
He has been laying a burden of His presence in my spirit. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And I have been thinking upon my life na nimekuwa nikijiuliza. What does it mean to have the presence of the Lord in my life?
Amen.
That has been my prayer from Monday till Friday.
Yes.
I was praying for the presence of the Lord in my life.
Yes.
The presence of the Lord in the church.
Yes.
The presence of the Lord in the entire body of Christ. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Ningeomba watu kadhaa wakapate kuwa na Biblia na wakaweze kunisomea.
Yeah.
I want somebody to read for me Genesis 39 and verse 3. I want somebody else to also read for me Genesis 39 and verse 21. In the mighty name of the Lord, as I lay a foundation of this word, in the name of the Lord. This is a series that I'm going to preach for 1 month. But today I am only laying a foundation of the word of God. And I have called it the presence of God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. What do we call presence in Kikamba? Withiamuanga. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. The presence of God.
Yes.
Ule amefika pale ningekuomba ukapata kunisomea. Genesis 39 and verse 3. Genesis 39 and verse 3 and also Genesis 39 and verse 21. Don't we have Bible readers in the kingdom of God? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Genesis 39 and verse 3 and also Genesis 39 and verse 21. If you are there by the grace of God, I would request you to just read it for me in the mighty name of the Lord.
When his master saw that the Lord
yes. Yes, could go in the 39 verse 21.
But the Lord was with Joseph and he gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison.
Thank you. We'll go to the book of Exodus 33 verse 13 to 14. Exodus 33 verse 13 to 14. And somebody else read for me Daniel chapter 3 and verse 25. In the name of the Lord. These are the verses we shall read throughout the month. In the name of the Lord. Exodus 33 verse 13 to 14. And somebody read for me Daniel chapter 3 and verse 25. Katika jina la Yesu. If you are there, just raise up your hand. Uletewe Michael kapate kutusomea. In the name of the May God bless you for reading his word in Jesus' name.
If you are pleased with me,
yes.
Teach me your ways.
Yes.
So I may know you and
yes.
Continue to find favor with you.
Amen.
Remember that this nation is your people.
Yes.
The Lord replied, my presence will go with you and I will give you rest.
Amen. Somebody read for me the other verse, Daniel 3:25.
Daniel 3:25.
Yes.
Look, he answered, I see 4 men loose walking in the midst of the fire.
Yes.
And they are not hurt. And the form of the 4th is like the son of the God. Nebuchadnezzar praises God.
Thank you, Jesus. I want you to read for me the very last verse, Isaiah 43, verse 1 to 2. Isaiah 43, verse 1 to 2. Ningekuomba ukuje on the other side, awa mepata baraka za kusoma sana. Come on the other side. I believe we have learned good people here. In the name of the Lord. Move to the other side. Isaiah 43, verse 1 to 2. Isaiah 43 verse 1 to 2, anaacha kuchukua baraka zote. Isaiah 43 verse 1 to 2, come let somebody read it from this side. In the mighty name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Isaiah 43 verse 1 to 2.
Isaiah 43 verse 1 to 2.
Yes.
But now, this is what the Lord says.
Yes.
He who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel,
yes.
Fear not,
yes.
For I have redeemed you.
Yes.
I have summoned you by my name.
Oh, yes.
You are mine.
Yes.
When you pass through the waters, I'll be with you.
Yes.
And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you.
Yes.
When you walk through the fire, they you'll not be burnt.
Yes.
The flames will not set you ablaze.
Yes.
For I am the Lord your God.
Amen.
The Holy One of Israel.
Amen.
Your Savior.
Glory to God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Thank you for the people that have read the word of the Lord with me today. Lord, I stand before your people today, and as a vessel, use me. Touch my tongue. May I speak what you want me to speak. all of you and none of me.
Amen.
May I speak from your courtyard, my Father.
Yes.
May I speak from your mind, my Father. For
yes.
I know that I carry the mindset of Christ.
Yes.
May I distill all the oracles of heaven to your loved ones.
Yes.
In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. 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 Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
So the word of the Lord today, I am going to talk about the presence of the Lord.
Yes.
The presence of the Lord. You've told me presence in Kikambani with Yanu. With Yanu wanga in my son, in my two.
Amen.
The presence of the Lord in our lives. Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
And I wanted, and as we are beginning the book of Genesis 39 and verse 3. Hapa tumesoma kuhusu mtu mmoja aliyekuwa anaitwa Yusufu.
Yes.
And because the presence of the Lord was with Joseph,
uh-huh.
the word of God tells me
uh-huh.
in Genesis 39 and verse 21
yes.
that because the presence of the Lord was with Jacob,
uh-huh.
all that Jacob did prospered, all that Joseph did prospered. But
Amen.
Yes, was the presence of the Lord
yes.
walked with Joseph.
Yes.
Alipokuwa nyumbani kwao, with yanuanga iwa inake.
Yes.
Alipokuwa amerushwa tapale kwa ile wena.
Amen.
The presence of the Lord was there.
Yes.
Wakati aliporushwa korokoroni,
Amen.
The presence of the Lord was with him.
Yes.
Wakati alipotolewa korokoroni, akapelekwa kwa nyumba ya Potifa.
Bwana
Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
The presence of the Lord was with him.
Yes.
That is why the wife of Potifa alimwangalia na akaona kijana mzuri.
Amen.
Why? Because the presence of the Lord was with him.
Amen.
Wakati ambapo neema ya Mungu iko katika maisha yako,
Amen.
Utaanza kupendeza hata kwa watu wengine.
Amen.
And my prayer for somebody today
Amen.
Is the way Joseph walked with the presence of the Lord.
Yes.
In our lives we will also walk with the presence
Amen.
Of the Lord. I declare by the anointing of the Lord of
yes.
this earth,
yes.
somebody you have struggled to have walked without the presence of God.
Amen.
I came to tell you, you don't need 1,000 prayers.
Amen.
I came to tell you, you don't need 80 days of prayer and fasting.
Yes.
I came to tell you, you don't need a jerrycan of anointing oil.
Yes.
All that you need is the presence of God.
Amen.
And today I feel it in my spirit
yes.
that somebody is receiving a new grace.
Yes.
I feel it in my spirit
yes.
that the presence of God is locating somebody in our
midst.
When Joseph alipokuwa nyumbani kwao, the presence was with him. Alipokuwa amerushwa kwa shimo, the presence was with him. That is why your shimo haikuwa na maji. Kwa nini? Kwa ajili Mungu alikuwa na yeye. Wakati ambapo alienda kurushwa korokoroni, tunaona hata the people there began to love him. Why? Because the presence of God was with him. Wakati alitolewa pale, akapelekwa kwa nyumba ya hata bibi ya Potifari akaanza kumumezea mate.
Yes.
Kwa nini? Because the presence of the Lord was with him.
Yes.
And I see a Joseph in my generation.
Yes.
Somebody that whenever you walk at, whenever you go to a place,
yes.
people will look at you and say, my God,
yes.
ule mtu ako na kitu ambacho wengine
hawana.
Somebody looking,
hey, yes.
somebody looking for a job.
Yes.
You just enter in that office.
Amen.
You just enter in that employment.
Yes.
And because people come with their papers,
Amen.
Others come with their big credentials,
yes.
others come with their diplomas, their degrees, their masters.
Yes.
But I prophesy to you,
Lord,
you will not go alone.
Yes.
You will go with the presence of God.
Amen.
Somebody declare the presence of God.
The presence of God.
The presence of God. Wakati Joseph alitupwa kwa shimo.
Yes.
There was no water.
Yes.
Why? Because he had the presence of God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. If there is one thing I desire,
mm-hmm.
if there is one thing I seek,
yes.
is the presence of God in my life.
Yes.
Without the presence of God, we are nothing. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. We can pray from morning till night,
yes.
but without his presence,
mm-hmm.
we are nothing.
Yes.
We can fast, we can anoint ourselves
yes.
from the head to the feet,
yes.
but without the presence of God,
yes.
we are nothing.
Yes.
And this is where many people are struggling, because the presence of the Lord left them a long time ago.
Yes.
The presence of God at some time
leaves.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
And this is what I love about our God.
Amen.
When he is with you,
yes.
there is nothing But the moment he leaves you, you become like Samson. The moment he leaves you, you become like Saul. And you begin asking yourselves, Ninona ndiye ndekeni matukwano wote tukiyanduka. Ninona ndumayuka kibanda nikuwa kweni matukwano kwendi yata. It is the presence of God. One thing that you should guard in your life is the presence of God not to leave you. Wana Yesu asifiwe. Somebody declare, God, may you never leave me alone.
God, may you never leave me alone.
We see a man by the name Samson. He killed an entire 3,000 and something people.
Yes.
The theologians said that they were more than this number that is given in the Bible. Now, aliwaua kwa fimbo ya farasi tu. That one was a mighty man.
Yes.
Alipotokea watu walikimbia. But there came a time.
Yeah.
Na akajitikisa hivi akapata hata kamba ezivunja. Akajitikisa hivi akapata hakuna kitu katika maisha yake.
Yeah.
And this is my prayer for you, loved one, in the kingdom of God.
Yes.
That you will never find yourself at a scenario without the presence of God.
Yeah.
May God correct you when you go wrong, but may he never leave you in this race.
Yes.
In the mighty name of the Lord. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And the Bible tells me,
yes,
in the book of Exodus 33 verse 13 to 14.
Yes.
Now huu ni wakati ambao, huu ni wakati ambao Moses walipokuwa jangwani.
Yeah.
And then the Lord was telling Moses, hawa watu wamenichosha. Lakini Moses, e yanga iwe uvungu. Utena kwa ntiuma baba. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. In order for you to get the presence of the Lord in your life, kitu moja Mungu wetu apendi. Mungu wetu apendi ungwana. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Ambia jirani yako ungwana. Mungu wetu apendi watu wanakuwa nao kama ziwalala. Mungu wetu apendi ungwana. Moses told God, my God, we ubungunga hii. Nundo nokenda nume wabanti umaba rote na kwa. And God in our generation, he's looking for people who are not after miracles. God is looking for people who are not after employment alone. God is looking for people who are not after getting what they need. In order for their life to be successful alone. Our God is looking for people who will say, without your presence, we cannot go. Without you, Lord, we cannot go to that job.
Nikoli
nimepata hiyo kazi, lakini nataka neema yako. Nikoli nimepata hiyo kazi, lakini bila wewe Mungu mimi siendi. Nikoli nimepata mchumba mzuri, lakini nataka neema yako. I need your presence more than I need your miracle. I need your presence in my life more than I need you to turn around my situation. Because I know if you be for me, nobody can be against me. Because I know greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. So Lord, what I need, I need your presence. Men and women of God, God is looking for people who are like Moses. Wanaomwambia Mungu, bila wewe siwezi. Bila wewe siendi mahali. Ni kweli people, ni kweli nimepata kazi fulani. But in that job I need your presence. Ni kweli nimepata rasilimali za kufungua biashara. Lakini Mungu, bila uwepo wako sitaweza. Bila uwepo wako sitaenda. Ni kweli Mungu, niko na school fees na niko shule. But I need your presence, oh God. Because with your presence I can do anything. God is looking for men and women in my generation. Who are saying we don't need anything more. We need the presence of God. Because we know if God is with us, everything that we want, we shall get. Somebody declare, I need the presence.
I need your presence.
I need the presence.
I need the presence.
When I ask what if you will.
Amen.
After the book of Malachi.
Yeah.
Malachi is the last book of the Old Testament.
Uh-huh.
And between Malachi and Matthew,
yes,
there is a period of 450 years. Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Hiyo
miaka Mungu akuongea. Hiyo miaka Mungu akutembea na watu wake.
Hiyo
miaka the Bible calls them the silent years.
Uh-huh.
God was silent on his people.
Yeah.
Because in the book of Malachi, if you look at the last word in Malachi, is curse. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Malachi closes with the word curse. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And the Lord for 450 years,
yes,
akunena na watu wake. 450 years, there were no prophets.
Yeah.
450 years,
yes,
there were no visions.
Yeah.
450 years,
yes,
there were no dreams.
Yeah.
450 years, nobody could stand and preach the gospel. 450 years without God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. But the Lord knew that these people cannot do without my presence. Kwa hivyo sio manabii nitatuma sasa. Kwa hivyo sio ishara nitatuma sasa. But in the book of Matthew, the Lord sends his only son in our lives. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I know in the service today, there is somebody who is in the period between Malachi and Matthew. Nothing is working, nothing is moving. It's as if God is silent on your case. But I want to tell you, it's because God does not want to send any prophet to you. It's because God does not want to send any vision to you. But the Lord wants to send his son. The Lord wants to come down by himself in your situation. So it is not about the prophet of Malachi. It is not about a guy. It is not about Hosea. It is not about the minor and the major prophets of the Old Testament. It is about the Son of Man in the book of Matthew. It is about Jesus himself meeting my condition. So I came to tell you, men and women of God, it's not a time for us to seek what men of God are doing. It's not a time for us to run from this church to that church. It's a time for us to say, we have dealt with Hosea, we have dealt with the Old Testament. Now I want to hear the Lord speaking in my situation. It's not the prophets I want. It's not the pastors I want. It's not the priests I want. It's not the teachers of law I want. But it is you, God, I want. And in the book of Matthew, he did not send any prophet. In the book of Matthew, he came down in the life of his son. Can I prophesy to you? In the name of the Lord, I declare in your life, where God is about to take you in the next phase of your life, it is not about a prophet taking you there. You know, when we men of God do something, many of the times we become proud. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And the Lord says he is God. He can never share glory with anyone. So whatever he does, if your miracle is bigger, it can never come through any man. If your miracle is bigger, it comes from God himself. How does God appear? In the times you least expect him, that is when the presence of God comes in. And I declare to somebody, you are in the Malachi season. But I want to tell you, Matthew is coming. When Matthew is coming, the Son of God is in Matthew. I want to tell you, you are in the period between Malachi and Matthew. Nothing is working, nothing is moving. But in the book of Matthew, there is the fullness of God. In the next season, there is the presence of God. In the season to come, the Son of God himself will begin to show up in your situation. Don't seek men to bless you unless they begin to brag about you. But seek for God to bless you, because he can never brag in your situation. Somebody say, I want the presence of God.
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 450 years, the Lord did not speak. The Bible calls it the silent ears. You are in the silent ears. Unaona Mungu ni kama amesahau. But I want to tell you, all that you are lacking is the presence of God. And I came as John the Baptist as a forerunner for what is about to happen in your life. I came to only announce, not to only say God is going to do through me. No. I came to announce that he that is coming is greater than he that is standing in front of you. I came to announce to you that the miracle that is coming, no man can take credit for it. Today I stand on this altar as a forerunner, as a messenger, as John the Baptist did in the book of Matthew. He was only a forerunner. And I came to tell you, it is God who is going to do that next miracle. It is the presence of God that is going to open those doors that you have been seeking people to open for you. I want to tell somebody, you have been putting your trust in somebody. Unagojea fulani akutafutie kazi. Unagojea fulani atende vile. Unagojea huyu afanye hivi ndiposa mambo ikue sawa. But I want to tell you, we don't need people alone. We need, mostly above everything, we need the presence of God. And I prophesy to somebody under the sound of my voice, that in this generation, in this next season of your life, it will not be about people taking credit for your blessing. It will be about God being called God in your situation. situation.
I receive.
He is God of the mountains. Yeah. He is God in the valleys.
Yes.
He is God in the evening.
Yes.
He is God in the morning.
Yes.
He is God when you are crying.
Yes.
He is God when you are rejoicing.
Yeah.
His name is Jehovah.
Yes.
He is the one that is going to release His presence in your life.
Yeah.
I pray that in my generation, that people will not walk without the presence of God. That the Lord will release His presence in our lives.
Yes.
I am going to talk about the presence of the Lord for the entire month. But as I conclude, I want to go to the book of Isaiah 43 verse 1 to 2. And the Bible says, the presence of the Lord will go with you. This is a prophetic word I came to give to somebody.
Yes.
The presence of God will go with you.
Amen.
I know you have struggled alone,
yes,
but I came to tell you, try Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
I know you have struggled alone,
yes,
but I came to tell you, people will not help you.
Yes.
Try Jesus.
Amen.
I know that you have been looking for a good partner.
Yes.
I came to tell you,
yes,
good partners come from the Lord.
Amen.
I know you have been looking for customers.
Yes.
Customers are not brought by Kamote alone.
Yes.
Yes, as if you
Kamotu
does not do anything to bring customers.
Yes.
It is only manipulation of the mind.
Amen.
Customers come from the Lord,
yes,
at their own appointed time.
Yes.
I want to tell you, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. It is not only by praying and crying to the Lord alone.
Yes.
It is by you praying and seeking the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
And not seeking His miracle. Kuza jirani yako mwambie achana na miujiza.
Achana na miujiza.
Taka Mungu kwanza.
Taka Mungu kwanza.
When the Lord comes in your life, miracles, signs,
yes,
wonders,
yes,
testimonies,
yes,
and everything that you need begins to follow you.
Yes.
So God is looking for a woman in my time.
Yes.
A woman in this generation.
Uh-huh.
A man in this generation.
Yes.
That is saying, I am not going to follow the things people are following.
Yes.
People want big cars and big homes.
Uh-huh.
But all I need God in my life.
Uh-huh.
I need His presence in my life.
Yes.
Because I know at the presence of the Lord,
yes,
there is fullness of joy.
Amen.
I know if the Lord is in me,
yes,
nobody can be against
Amen.
Me. And the Lord says in the book of Psalms,
uh-huh,
even if a thousand will fall at your right,
yes,
and a thousand at your left,
Amen,
He will deliver you from them all.
Amen.
So I know if the Lord is with me,
yes,
I am not even going to fear a thousand people against me.
Yes.
Or a thousand people against me.
Uh-huh.
Because I know He will deliver me.
Yes.
Seek the presence of God, people of God. Life without God is struggle.
Bwana
Yesu asifiwe. Life without God is struggle.
Yes.
As I am concluding, I was only laying a foundation.
Yes.
This is a message that I'm going to preach for 4 Sundays.
Yes.
In the name of the Lord.
Yes.
I continue next Sunday, and as the Spirit directs, we shall continue speaking about the presence of God.
Amen.
But as we go on, I want to urge you today.
Amen.
And everything else in this world is a passing cloud.
Yes.
But one thing will remain.
Amen.
And that is the presence of God in your situation.
Oh, yes.
Men may leave you,
yes,
but the presence of God does not leave you easily.
Amen.
The Bible tells me,
yes,
a righteous man falls 7 times,
yes,
and he raises again.
Amen.
The Bible also tells me,
uh-huh,
many are the afflictions of the righteous.
Yes.
Unapotaabika, usione kama ni kitu kisicho cha kawaida.
Uh-huh.
The Bible says, utataabika, but the Lord will deliver you from those afflictions. Men and women of God, afflictions will come.
Yes.
People will hate you. People will criticize you.
Yes.
Situations will eat you.
Yes.
Things will make you look bad.
Yes.
Delay will be there.
Uh-huh.
Things will not work in your situation.
Yes.
But one thing that the Lord promises us,
uh-huh,
if my presence is with you,
yes,
I shall deliver you from it all.
Uh-huh.
In this next week, I want you to go with one prayer point.
Uh-huh.
Pray for the presence of God. Pray for the presence of God.
Amen.
It is only God,
yes,
that cannot leave you. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. It is only God,
yes,
that cannot leave you.
Leave
alone, leave alone the things of this world.
Yes.
Leave alone the papers that can speak well of you in good places.
Amen.
Leave alone the people that you know that can speak well of you.
Yes.
Leave alone the people that can comment you.
Uh-huh.
Leave alone even the way you know to pray,
yes,
the way you know to interpret the scripture.
Uh-huh.
That one does not matter in this situation.
Uh-huh.
What matters is if God is with you.
Bwana
Yesu asifiwe.
Uh-huh.
Saul was still the king,
uh-huh,
and the Lord had left him.
Uh-huh.
You can still be praying and crying to the Lord,
uh-huh,
but the presence is not there.
Uh-huh.
You can still know how to interpret the scripture,
uh-huh,
but the presence Jesus is not there. But our prayer today is that we shall never in this life, we shall never walk without the presence of God. Somebody declare, I shall never walk without the presence of God in my life.
Walk without the presence of God.
In the name of the Lord, I want us to stand. I want us to stand in the presence of God. In the name of the Lord. I want to for only 2 minutes go before the Lord. I know we are behind time. For only 2 minutes go before the Lord. Tell the Lord, ninakuhitaji wewe. I need your presence. I need your presence. Ni wewe ninayehitaji. Nikijaribu peke yangu baba ni nitashindwa. If I say I will make it my God, I will be a liar. But if you stand with me, I know even through the still waters of life I shall walk. Through the learners in this place, tell the Lord, I know the concepts of learning is very hard. I know that chemistry, physics and every other subject may be very tricky. But with you, I know everything will be okay. People who are looking for employment, tell the Lord, doors can shut if I don't walk with you. But if I walk with you, doors will begin to open by themselves. Kuna wale wako kwa biashara, biashara ya kuuza manyanya, biashara ya mutabaka, biashara tofauti tofauti. Tell the Lord, Lord, without you I will not see any customer. But with your presence I know you will pull them to me. Because you say where you are risen, you shall pull many unto you. There are many who are in the corporate offices, working at different platforms. Tell the Lord, Lord, I need you in that workplace. In that office, I need you. In the place of my labor, I need your presence. Somebody is talking about my family. Tell the Lord, Lord, I need your presence in my family. Some people here have great ministries. The Lord has called you in a different way. Tell the Lord, Lord, I need your presence. Without you, I cannot walk alone. Don't be silent before the Lord. You know the book of Corinthians tells me salvation is foolishness to those who are perishing. Just raise your voice. Tell the Lord, Lord, I need your presence. 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 What am I without you, God?
We need your presence, I said, I, my Father, and my God. We need your presence, my Father. We desire to walk with you, my Father.
Ourselves, our families, our workplaces, our neighbors, our nation, our church at large, my Father. But Lord, one thing that we need above all these things, we need your presence. We need you to walk with us. We need you to walk with us, my Father. There are doors that have not opened because you are not with us. There are people that have left our lives because you are not with us. There are things that we should have right now, but we don't have them because your presence is not with us. But today we are not seeking for these good things of life. We are seeking for your presence. Because you know if we have you in our lives, everything that we seek will be okay with us. We know if we seek your kingdom and righteousness, every other thing shall be added unto us. So as a church today, it's you we need, Lord. It's you we
we want, Lord. It's your grace, it's your intervention we need, Lord. It's you we need to look at our lives and say, surely, this is the hand of God. Miracles are good, blessings are good, but above all these things, it's you we need. In our generation, in our church, in our times, it's you we need. Lord, bless it and every presented on this platform. I pray, Lord, that you may bless them and bless them exceedingly. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, I pray and believe. Amen. 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 Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Ningeomba mkapate kuketi katika jina la Yesu. And as you go home, today go with one prayer point. Seek the presence of the Lord. Next Sunday will be third, and it will be the first Sunday of the month. So we are going to